be continuing. I'll be continuing with levels, that is the techniques or the technology used behind the IoT system. Okay, so when we discuss the technology, so we can categorize it as first the device platforms consisting of hardware, or software. Then it is microcontrollers to acquire or to control. Then I can categorize it as software for device APIs, that is the communication, then connecting and networking, then server and web programming. Later, it is cloud platform for storage, or it can be for computing also. Finally, it is data analytics, that is visualization, and sometimes if required, machine learning. Okay. Now, in the hardware, we have Arduino, Raspberry Pi, Intel Edison, Mbed, BeagleBone Black, and wireless SoC, silicon on chip. Okay, next comes the part. Next part in that is integrated development environment and software. Like, how do you club? How do you interface those? All the devices comes here. Now, it enables developing device software, firmware, and APIs. Now, here some of the examples are Eclipse IoT Stack, Sense, ThingWorx, NVThing, and the software, what we have, RIoT OS, and Eclipse IoT, etc. Now, embedded devices are that is REST, full HTTP, MQTT, XMPP. These are actually the platforms for the communication protocols. Also, it can be like RFID, NFC, ZigBee, Bluetooth, all these, Powerline, Ethernet. But if you use Ethernet, it has to be like line communication. It can be an IoT, but not wireless. Next, coming to protocol, network protocols, what we use are ZigBee IP, Wi-Fi, WiMAX, IPv4, IPv6 for all the all generation communication. Now, software platform, what we use are InterNetwork cloud platforms. That is Nimbits, TCS Connected Universe Platform. All these names, if you remember, Cisco IoT, IBM BlueMix, names, if you remember, it is sufficient. But the levels, what we are seeing, those levels you need to mention. Examples are not, one or two examples, if you remember, that is sufficient. Next level is, in the technology, what we design is analyzing and visualizing. Here, analyzing the data, streaming the data, this can be descriptive, prescriptive, or predictive analytics. And it can also can be for data visualization. Next comes, here, now these two are very much actually like overlined. Like sometimes we can segregate it, or sometimes we can club these technologies. Now, analytics here also is there analyzing. Same thing here, analytics and machine learning. Now we can use the data for the analytics, and we can give it for machine learning. So most of you, I think you have undergone some of the one of the training in machine learning. Now machine learning is, it is analyzing using the machines. Machine tool, we are analyzing the whatever the acquired data is there, that is sent to the machines. And it is like, it can be, the previous data can be taken as the training datas. So your machine will get, your tool will get trained depending on that data. Okay, then when you give the present data, okay, it is taken as a test data, and then it is it gives the prediction. It just gives the prediction. Okay, so that prediction for how far it is true, that is like still it is going, I mean, it depends on the efficiency, but that is actually analytics and data, like machine learning. Now this is used for some of the IoTs. Don't think that this, okay, all these levels are used for all, every IoT application what you do, need not be. Okay, analyzing data, it is done, the data is acquired and it has to be analyzed. Otherwise, why are we taking the data? It has to be analyzed. But how do you analyze it? Is it using like manual analyzing or is it machine learning? That is depending on the application. Okay. Yeah, it is the learning ability to learn continuously from data. That's what I said, training data, and the ability to drive actions, applications, machine learning algorithms. Many machine learning algorithms are there. For example, one here written is GROK from Numenta. Next comes major components of the IoT system. Now here the main component is sensors. Okay, next comes control systems. Now in sensors, we have yesterday in the introductory class, I have said, there are two types of sensors. One is analog sensor, okay, which is thermistors, photoconductors, pressure gauge, and so on. Okay, or else we can have digital sensors, okay, touch sensor, proximity sensor, metal sensor, all those things, okay? Okay, or we can have a custom chip. Okay, custom chip is you have designed for that particular application. That also we can have, so microcontroller. Okay. Popular microcontrollers that everybody knows. Okay. Now, the main parts of the microcontroller. Like you, this processor will be there, internal RAM will be there. Okay, one thing you need IoT, it will not have